Welcome back to the zeppearl channel. It's me, VK, your host, and hanging out here in the zeppearl hangar, I thought I'd do a little spotlight video on the band Cactus. I wanted to show you some of the records I have and, you know, throw some clips in at the end of the concert I saw a few years back. Cactus formed late 69, 1970. You got two members, kind of like a super group, man. You had two members from Vanilla Fudge, Carmine Appice, and Tim Bogart. Then you had Jim McCarthy from, I think it was the Detroit Wheels. And then Rusty Day, who he was in Amboy Dukes, I think. So kind of like a little super group there, and going for that kind of blues, heavy rock kind of stuff, you know. They were kind of labeled as the American Led Zeppelin. Carmine being buddies with John Bonham and that heavy sound. And actually, Carmine was the guy that got John Bonham the Ludwig drums endorsement. And Bonham was a big fan of Carmine's too, so a little Zeppelin tangent. But on their debut album, they even thank Led Zeppelin, as well as Jeff Beck. And Jeff Beck actually was supposed to be in this band, but for whatever reason, things didn't work out. But they released in 1970 this debut album, Killer Blues Rock. I don't know if you haven't heard this, give it a listen. If you like that kind of, you know, early 70s guitar-oriented blues rock, check it out. Some really killer tunes on here. Parchment Farm, No Need to Worry, Feels So Good. I mean, just really good stuff on this. Really clean copy I got here. I found this, it was like a little stereo shop that's not too far. It's like a bus ride away. And they have like maybe three or four just little rows of records. That's it. I mean, just bins rather, like three little, you know, bins. And whatever reason, I came across this, still kind of in the string, barely. But I had to pick it up. I think they had it maybe 10, 15 bucks, maybe a little more towards the 15 side. But really clean copy. And I never really came across it, so definitely had to grab it on Echo Records. And there's the old Echo label. Echo being a subsidiary of Atlantic Records. So yeah, man, Killer Blues Rock. Check it out. The first Cactus album in 1970. Actually, the first album I got from them actually was the second album. I first found this at Reckless Records a while back. And I mean, it has to have been a good 6-7 years now. But one way or another, the second Cactus album that came out in 1971. And, you know, these guys didn't get a lot of radio airplay that I know of. I think they should have been a lot bigger. You should see them being talked about more often, I think. But again, killer just blues rock, heavy rock stuff from these guys. And then, you know, they did, I think, an album or two after this. I think they split up around 73, 74 for whatever reason. Not really sure. But they would reform later in 2006. Well, just they reformed in 2006 with a new lineup. Carmine is still the main guy in it. Got a new singer, Jimmy Coons, and you know, some other players. But I wanted to talk about this. I have to give a little shout out to Grown Man Record, Mikey Bananas, and the rest of the guys over here. I had it been 3-4 weeks ago or so, Mikey Bananas was doing, you know, in the beginning of the show, they usually talk about their new releases that are coming out on records and stuff. And Mikey showed this Cactus, The Birth of Cactus 1970. And when he showed it, man, I just jumped right online and picked it up during the show. I think it was on Cleopatra Records, or right on the site to pick it up. This is a live Cactus album from 1970, Philadelphia show. You know, look at that cover. That's just cool, right? This really pops. And then you got this gatefold, nice gatefold. You got a picture of the crew there, the band. You got this old show poster. Look at that lineup there, man. You had Cactus opening up for Steve Miller Band, Grateful Dead, Jimi Hendrix. Crazy. What a show that would be. So yeah, I had to pick this up, and this is just killer. Great live show. I seen another album I might pick up too from 71, another live album on them. But found this on Cleopatra Records. Gonna do a little needle drop here for you. I think the second tune, Sweet 16. Check it out as the Harleys go by in the middle of winter. What? That ain't no Harley. All right, here's a little needle drop, Sweet 16 from Cactus Live 1970, The Birth of Cactus. Go live Cactus 1970 from the album The Birth of Cactus. Check that out, man. Check this out if you can. Pick it up, give it a listen. VK approved. Also want to talk, like I said earlier, they reformed kind of in 2006 with a new lineup and had Jimmy Coons on there. In 2018 they released an album called Black Dawn. This is killer, man. In fact, I have it playing now. Hopefully you can hear it in the background and I don't get a copyright strike. Just great album, man. Really surprised with this one. I picked this up at the show that I went to, and I was really, really pleased with the outcome of it. So going into that, man, I went to go see Cactus back on in 2018. It was June 22nd here at Reggie's Rock Club in Chicago, and just like a small clip from that show. Cactus Live at Reggie's back in June of 2018 in support of the album Black Dawn. You can tell, man, it was just a bluesy rock show. And before the show, the guys were hanging out in the bar and they were really, everybody was super cool. I got to briefly meet Carmine and chatted with Jimmy Coons, the singer. And then after the show, the guys came out and signed stuff, obviously. So I ripped this kind of poster thing. This was like a display advertisement on the wall in the bar. I took that off the wall because I had nothing to sign. And then I also bought a CD. So yeah, I got Carmine signed on the CD and Jimmy, if you can see it there, little black squigglies. And then they also got him to sign the poster. Everybody except the guitarist, which, what is his name? Jimmy Pratt or something like that. Randy, no. Lead guitar, let's see. Yeah, I think it was Randy Pratt or whatever. But they signed this. I got everybody here to sign that. Carmine in the center there. Jimmy's down here somewhere across here. Yeah. So got them to sign out, which was totally cool. They were very cool. Didn't do any pictures or anything like that. But, and then, yeah, again, the CD. It was just great to see Carmine because, you know, just the history of that and obviously with Zeppelin and everything, it was just that, you know, 1 degree, you know, next to Bonham. So I'm gonna leave you with the drum solo, Carmine Appice, from the show. It's about 2 minutes long. Check this out. Carmine on drums doing what he does best. Carmine Appice from the band Cactus performing live at Reggie's back in June of 2018. So that's kind of wraps it up. I mean, I just wanted to show some records, show those clips. Did you ever see Cactus? Were you a fan? Do you have any of these records? Do you have any of the ones I don't have? I'd like to see if I can find some of those. You have a favorite album or song or something like that, let me know. But thanks for tuning in to the Zeppearl channel. That's a feature on Cactus with some clips from the show. And that's it. That's all I got. Take care, everybody. Thanks for tuning in.